I guess your first chance to react to the award yesterday and winning player of the year, you want to just talk about what that means and how helpful or whatever to, for the team?
It means a lot. You know, I try not to focus on the accolades too much because I know there's so much work that I have to do, so many more games to play. But I just take it one day at a time. You know, thank God for blessing me with the opportunity to be player of the year and just continue to help the team get better and better each and every day.
But given the sometimes erratic nature of your game, is there a statement there that you were able to pursue or, you know, push through that and pick up an award like that?
There was a lot. I've been working like really, really hard a lot lately, and I think, you know, my hard work is showing that it's paying off. So like I said, I just need to continue to work hard.
Meighan, you may not want to talk about yourself, but what about Bashara, the accolade she got?
Oh, wow. You know, we're so proud of Bashara, and Bashara is well deserved for that. She's worked so hard. She doesn't play like a freshman. She plays like upperclassmen. She continues to get better each and every day, and I'm very proud of her.
Obviously, your numbers are a whole lot better this year than last year, but in your eyes, where do you think is the biggest area in which you've improved?
I've really worked on my defensive end, and I think that's something that really has helped me get the player of the year because they've seen that I've been working hard on both ends of the floor. And I just keep improving every day on the defensive end, and the coaches have told me, you know, I'm getting better and better each and every day, so I take that as motivation to keep working on it.
How much was that emphasized to you before this season, that this was something, an area where you were going to need to kind of take it to the next level?
Oh, it was emphasized a lot, especially over the summer and things like that, because that's one of the things that I wanted to focus on, because I needed something else to help me get easier buckets to start off the game and then just let the offensive end come to me and just continue to work hard.
How motivated is this team going to pull off the double-double? You know, it's not easy to do, win the regular season and the tournament. What's the motivation level right now?
It's really high, and I think our energy is very high. I mean, we're very excited. We had a very good practice yesterday. Today, we should have a very good practice and just getting prepared each and every day and learning from the mistakes that we've made against Kentucky and continue to move forward and make sure, you know, we just work hard 10 times harder.
Meighan, the last 2 years, you guys have played really well. The team's played really well in this tournament. Can you look back on those tournaments and what's been the reason that those teams have played so well?
We played together. I mean, we moved the ball very well. You know, we pressed, we got the ball in transition, we made the easier baskets to start off in the earlier in the game, and we made sure we stuck to the game plan, and I think this one made it easier for us to win games.
Having had 5 days in between Kentucky game and playing on Friday, how ready are you to put that game behind you and play another game?
Right after, you know, we got on the bus, I was like, you know what, this game is over. I'm just going to focus on the new season that's coming up as far as SEC is concerned. And I try not to dwell on negativity, you know, because when we lose, you know, it's a negative thought in the back of my mind. I don't want to dwell on something negative. I want to think on the positive of how we can redeem ourselves as far as the SEC tournament.
How big a blow was that, though, to not just drop that game, but to, you know, last game of the regular season and last game before you sort of set the tone, or as you set the tone for the tournament? How big a shockwave was that, I guess, on Sunday for you?
It really was. I mean, it was a wake-up call that we need to not, you know, play down to our opponent, play under, you know, what we're used to playing and playing Tennessee basketball. And we just didn't play up to the level that we were supposed to. And I think that's one of the things that keeps us from being one of the top teams, is that we have to be consistent. We have to go out there, play hard, give it our all, 110%, not just from one person or two people, but from everybody.
Because it's a team you could face in the title game, is there any concern there?
I don't think there is a concern. I think there's more of a hunger there. Because, you know, even though we lost, you know, we always bounce back very well. And I think this time we're really going to bounce back.
Meighan, how difficult is it for this team? It seems like every game that you're dealing with some sort of injury, in some cases to multiple kids. You didn't have Izzy on Sunday. Mm-hmm. I mean, what's the challenge like from game to game dealing with this?
It's a really big challenge because you never know who's going to show up. I mean, but you should always be ready, you know, because when, you know, there's a couple people, you know, who don't play, but when that opportunity comes, you know, they just got to be ready to play. And I think, you know, we've handled it very well, you know, as far as, you know, injuries are concerned. And we've actually, you know, taken it one game at a time, you know, given people who need to recover, gave them time to recover. And everybody else has done a very good job of stepping up and knowing their roles out there on the floor.
Meighan, what did the team say to Holly about the SEC Coach of the Year honors?
In the huddle yesterday, you know, that was the first thing that we mentioned, you know, at the end of practice, that we were very happy for her. And one of the things that I, you know, expressed to her was that, you know, in the midst of, you know, all the struggles that we've had over the season, you know, she got Coach of the Year because of how well she's handled us as players and as as players off the floor and on the floor. And she's done a very good job with us. You know, she's learned a lot from us. You know, each and every game she learned something different about each and every one of her players, and she's taking it in.
Candace Parker said something on Twitter about you getting Player of the Year and how she would have had to have gotten very angry if you didn't. Did you see that tweet? Have you had any time to talk to Candace?
I haven't. But to hear something like that, I mean, it just puts me amongst, you know, a lot of the great people that have come through here, and it's really a blessing, and it's very humbling. And, you know, I don't ever talk about myself, because I'm not a very, you know, cocky person or arrogant person, but I take everything one day at a time and take every blessing that comes towards me and take advantage of it, hold it in, and just keep moving forward.
But that is your favorite player. It's nice to be in that company, isn't it?
That is. It really is a blessing.
It seems a lot of these conference games, purely the close wins y'all have had on the road, you've kind of taken over at some point offensively. And I mean, how difficult was it for you to kind of take that mentality, take that upon yourself to be able to take over a game down the stretch when you've had to?
It can be difficult at times, you know, because you never know, like, what's going to happen. You know, I don't know when my shot's just going to go in all the time. You know, my shot doesn't go in all the time. But when that time does come and the coaches, you know, start to draw out plays and things like that, I have to take that responsibility on myself and make sure not only on the offensive end but on the defensive end. You know, sometimes they'll tell me, you know, go steal the ball and, you know, get yourself going and, you know, help us get back in the game. But like I said, it's just a responsibility that I have, and that's a part of my role out there on the floor.